B Monster Laboratory here. Today I'm going to show you how to give MOVI a new name and a new voice. Welcome back. I'm Brad. This is MOVI. It's a voice control shield for your Arduino board. And I didn't know exactly how much material to put in this video, so it's going to be fairly short as I'm just showing you how to change the call sign and use the different voices available in your free example code. So let's go ahead and begin. Well, here's MOVI connected and ready to go. Be sure to plug in the external power first. If you haven't seen that first video that I made on this, I will link it in the description below. Make sure you check that out. The first thing we'll do here is open the example code and check out our voice options. Now, once you download the MOVI library, you're going to have example code called Synthesizer Control. We're going to go in here and listen to all the voices available to us with this library. Now, once it's uploaded, you're going to be able to hear the default voice, a female voice, a whispering voice, a child voice, a voice that speaks really fast, one that speaks really slow, and this is also where you can change the volume if you wish to do so.
Hello, this is the default voice.
Hello, this is the female voice.
Do not tell anybody that MOVI can whisper now.
MOVI can creep you out too.
Or speak like a child.
Or extremely fast, 1, 2, 3, 4. Or very slow, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
As of firmware 1.1, I am the additional female voice. Fancy an American accent? Y puedo hablar castellano.
Changing the volume using the code is an option, but I prefer using a speaker with a volume knob.
50% volume.
Now let's go ahead and add some of these voices to the example code we used in the first video. Now with the synthesizer control code open, I'm going to go ahead and open another example code called Light Switch 3. That's the one we used previously. I'm just going to put them side by side and pick whatever voice I want to transfer from synthesizer control over to the Light Switch 3. In this video, you're going to see how user-friendly and beginner-friendly all this really is, and everything I'm doing here can be done by anybody. Now, I want to choose what voice I want to use on the left. I want to use this female voice, so I highlight recognizer.set voice gender female voice, and then I paste it in my Light Switch 3 code on the right, and I want to paste it right above the recognizer.say line to give it that voice. So I'll pick a couple voices from here, and then we'll listen to it in the end. Arduino. Light.
On and off.
On.
On and off.
On.
And there was light.
Arduino. Off.
Good night.
I have a loud background, so it did have a little bit of trouble hearing me. Now, I decided not to use my lapel mic for this, and it turned out to be kind of a mistake because it is a little bit noisy in the background, so it's having some trouble hearing. But we're going to change a call sign. We're going to rename MOVI from Arduino to David. And the PDF file that you can download does give some good information on what makes a good call sign. For instance, they say to choose words that are distinctive from other words and words that have multiple syllables. Those words work really well, like computer or MOVI.
MOVI is loading a new call sign. Please do not unplug the power. Training finished. Unplugging is safe. One moment, please. MOVI is ready. The call sign is David.
David. David. Light.
On and off.
On.
On and off.
On.
And there was light.
David. David. Off.
Good night.
Well, I had to call David's name a couple times. Sorry about that. It does normally work better than that, but like I said, it is a little bit noisy. Be sure to check out my first video so that you can hopefully get a little more information about this. As always, thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell notification button. And I'll see you again very soon.